You don't have to appreciate something just because it's beautiful, but birds are fascinating. Their anatomy, their plumages, they're such an amazing product of the environment that they're coming from. I'm Jillian Ditner. I work at the Cornell Lab of Ornithology as a graphics editor, designer, and science illustrator. So even at a time where we have like amazing access to different technology and obviously huge database of photography, it's still important to have that artist's hand come in. The value there is that as many photographs as you have, you'll never capture all the views or angles of a subject that you want to express for a certain purpose. The ideal illustration will capture, you know, everything it needs to. You can change the angle, you can pose it the way you need to. The lighting can be adjusted, the colors can be, you know, tweaked to be more accurate. So an illustration can just cover so much more than one photograph, or even many photographs can.
Let's go grab some birds. I mean, this was my first experience collaborating with an artist for a paper, and it was really cool for me because I think I saw just how powerful it is when you can work with somebody who's talented and knows how to translate these really dense scientific topics for broader audiences.
The wings come just beyond the tail. Mm-hmm.
On both species?
Yes.
So when I first approached Jillian, one of the major motivations is that we really wanted to be able to show readers what these two super cryptic, very subtly different, massive brown hummingbirds looked like. And so I was sort of piecing through, like, exactly what are these really fine scale differences? How can we tell them apart? How can I show readers that they're really so similar, but also really different when you know what to look for? And Jillian has such a keen eye and was great. We talked through color, we talked through layout, we talked through a million iterations of how to structure the feathers and do we want it detailed here? Or do we want it broader picture here so that people can kind of focus on certain aspects and forget about others. So we talked a lot about the kind of philosophy of illustration and techniques to use to make these pop. And like I would not have been able to bring this to life without Jillian because I cannot do this myself and I don't have these skills and I don't see what she sees. And so it was really fun to be able to work with somebody who's trained to think like she does to really, you know, give this story, I think, a powerful component that was very much at a big added value.
The Bartels Science Illustration Program has been around for 20 years plus. We've hosted over 30 illustrators, and it's such a unique program because we bring artists in to work full-time at the lab for a paid position, and they're learning from mentors such as myself and all the experts at the lab, different scientists, science communicators, and it's really a unique position.
My name is Lauren Richelieu, and I am the Bartels Science Illustrator at the Lab of Ornithology.
This is probably one of the few programs that I have learned of that actually provides sort of a mentorship kind of opportunity. So I feel like going from not really having that to having that has been really amazing because I feel like I can actually, you know, spend time one-on-one learning things and discussing my work and how I can improve it. And Jillian also knows so much and is able to point out things that I didn't necessarily notice. So I feel like my eye is kind of being trained a little bit more.
I like how you incorporated Kevin's comments about the crest because that was something that was standing out as like, how does that balance between?
I really care about nature and the environment. I've kind of always been like, trying to be a like climate change activist, so being able to contribute in my way, especially since I'm not a scientist and not going to be a scientist, it's nice that I can kind of do something that will help in some way.
Yeah, I mean, it is wonderful to see your work out and about. I love seeing the pieces that I've been able to contribute to, but for me, I think a big part of it is knowing that work hopefully furthers a goal of conservation or awareness. That's always been important in my work. And as a younger artist, I always found found the satisfaction in seeing things published, but not necessarily the fulfillment. And so for me, it's just really wonderful to be contributing to projects that actually are hopefully doing something to conserve birds.